estimated 4.9 million suffer from hunger. Around 66 million Filipinos, or 70% of the population, are struggling to survive on 100 pesos or less daily. The highest mandated minimum wage is 466 pesos. However, family living wage is 1,054 pesos, which more than 32 million live in slums, while 1.2 million children live on the streets. 4.4 million Filipinos are unemployed, while 7.2 million are underemployed. 9 out of 10, or 86% of unemployed Filipinos, are high school graduates or have attended college. Fair and toll fee prices continue to rise due to increasing oil prices. There is also a looming increase of MRT-LRT fares. Prices of basic services such as water and electricity continuously escalate. The price of electricity in the Philippines is the most expensive in Asia. $4,800 Filipinos leave the country every day.
Para hindi maging marat, maging magulo yung gagawin na demolition, ay pagkakataon na nyo na pagbigyan nyo yung local government kung anong gusto nila.
More than 4,000 victims in demolition of urban poor communities in 2011.
Filipino under martial law.
I am Edith Burgos and I am the mother of Jonas Burgos. In April 28, 2007, my son Jonas was abducted in a mall in Quezon City. He was 37 at that time. My youngest son is more aware about cases of abductions, about human rights violations, was already aware that these things could happen because Jonas was really an activist and he was always with farmers' groups and teaching them their rights, and possibly he could have incurred the ire of the military.
It's almost 6 years now. Ako po ay araw-araw naghahanap ng justisya.
Ng aking ama ang diktadurya at ibinuwis niya ang kanyang buhay para tubusin ang ating demokrasya. Inalay ng aking ina ang kanyang buhay upang pangalagaan ang demokrasyang ito. Ilalaang ko ang aking buhay para siguraduhin na ang ating demokrasya ay kapaki-pakinabang sa bawat isa.
There is a common notion that the defense of human rights is the business of activists alone. If by activists we refer to people who desire change for all, then we owe a lot. This country owes a lot to activists. They are in the government, they are in the private sectors, they are in the church, they are in the academia, each one doing their own way to initiate change, a change for the better, and a change for all of us. From the perspective of the National Council of Churches in the Philippines, the defense of human rights is a responsibility for all Christians. We work hard so that our families can have secure dwellings, sufficient food, education for our children, and health, all towards the building up of a loving and caring society as well as a robust nation. We work hard so that no one oppresses the other on whatever grounds, be it ethnicity, and especially with respect to the equitable sharing of the resources which are God's providence for all people.
Sabay nating tanimang binhi ng paglaya sa bayan. Sabay nating diligin ang pag-ibig ng agad ay umusbong. Isang araw ay aanihin natin ang tagumpay, at sabay nating tatamasahin ang masaganang buhay. Sabay nating itanim ang binhi ng katarungan sa bayan. Sabay nating diligin ang pag-ibig ng agad ay umusbong. Isang araw ay aanihin natin ang tagumpay, at sabay nating tatamasahin ang mapayapang buhay. Kaya't huwag kang titigil at susuko sa pagpunla at paghahasik ng kalayaan. Ang ating pagkakaisa'y patibayin, at ang ating pagkilos ay lalong pag-alabing.